Well, at this point, I'm guessing maybe you're still at something of a loss. Right? You don't really want to go down the idealist route. That's fine. I'm not saying you have to. Let's take a look at what Philonous has to say. We're going to take a look at his argument. You've seen this before. We're going to take a look at the argument. We're going to pull out the premises, right, and see what it means to reject any one of the premises. Because there is a deductively valid version of this argument we can construct, basically following Philonous. And if we reject the conclusion, we have to reject at least one of the premises. And each rejection, right? Each rejection means you're committed to its logical contradictory. So let's try this. All right. So we had Philonous's argument before. I'm just going to briefly go over it. Right. So he's assuming, right, if color, figure, and extension are my mind only, then there's something supporting color, figure, and extension. Right. This is the conclusion of Hylas's argument. And what he's doing is he's assuming this for the sake of reductio ad absurdum, right? So you can take that, show a contradiction, therefore you reject the initial premise, right? If there's something supporting color, figure, and extension, then it does not have or it's without color, figure, and extension, right? So material substance is beneath the color, figure, and extension, right? And is supporting it. Making it happen, so to speak. So in today's language, right, we talk about the chemical composition of things. We had the electromagnetic radiation coming in through the windows, bouncing off of my shirt and causing, you know, through a series of causal events, right, causing the various sensations, blue, light blue, white, that you're experiencing. Okay. If there is something without color, figure, and extension, then it does not exist, right? This is the statement of empiricism. Right? If you can't experience it, it doesn't exist. If you can't experience it, you don't know it. Right? If I believe in what I see, right? This is a common thing. If I can see it, I believe it. That's all that statement is, that there's something without color, figure. If there's something, it's almost like a contradiction, right? It's almost an absurdity. If there's something without, that can't be experienced, then it doesn't exist. That's what the second statement is. Third one, if there's something without color, figure, and the third statement, if there's something without color, figure, and extension, it does not exist. Fourth one, if it does not exist, then there's not something supporting color, figure, and extension, right? So nothing can support color, figure, and extension. So we carry out the implications, premises 2, 3, 4, if color, figure, and extension are my mind only, then there is not something supporting color, figure, and extension. This is kind of the point that Berkeley's trying to make, right? I mean, this is the crux of his complaint about material substance, right? If there's something, if the color, figure, and extension are my mind only, then there's not something supporting them. Right? So color, figure, and extension are my mind only is kind of this initial statement that he says, right? So we carry out the implications again using that sixth premise and the first. So there is something supporting color, figure, and extension. We also, with that sixth premise and the fifth, all right, then we have there is not something supporting color, figure, and extension, and then boom, we have our contradiction. And then in that premise, there is something and there is not something. Well, that all resulted from the first premise, right? So Berkeley says, give up on the first premise. It's false that the color, figure, and extension are my mind only. Okay. So the premises that all this relies upon are these four premises. If there's something supporting color, figure, and extension, then is without color, figure, and extension. If there's something without color, figure, then it does not exist. If it does not exist, then it can't support anything. So, and color, figure, extension are my mind only. These four premises are what his argument relies upon. If you reject his conclusion, you got to reject one of these four premises. Right? And so if you do that, right, if you do that, rejecting the first one commits you the A premise, commits you to the logical contradictory. There is something supporting color, figure, and extension, and it has color, figure, and extension. Or B, the rejection of B, the logical contradictory is, there is something without color, figure, and extension, and it exists. C, rejecting C, commits to the contradictory. It, that is, that does not have color, figure, and extension, does not exist, and there is something supporting color, figure, and extension. And finally, the logical contradictory to D, is it is false that color, figure, and extension are my mind only. Okay, so if you reject his conclusion, you're committed to rejecting one of those premises. You reject a premise, you're committed to his logical contradictory, which is those last four. So, Which one and why?